Matavanai, tutti in Jehova. I Gianara Pedri, tu mai lavo fai tiri, me na uida. I dottoria te. I dottoria da te, te hapua. Ti matavara, te ibi tanga, te faga meninga. Ti matanga hudira, te ibi tanga. O mato, o te whakamininga. Koere ka huri atu ra ke mato, ko aro atu nei ki pene ra. O whiturangi te ato mato ka mato, a ben moronga. E ki ana rae tono, tono leo, whakamitunga kia tene rōpū. Kia tīmata a te pahi kia whakamutunga. Nō re rono tōkau tō kurori a tanga āwhina tia nei mātou te kaukapane. I roto huki te wawata o mātou mātou a tūkona, o mātou koi kuia, o haere a tūra te te tarō. O koe e koutai huki wai rua mai i tēne hauka, i āwhina i a mātou, e toho tohu i a mātou. I te mahi nā mahi i wahi o te mea o nā tūkuna, nā ariki, nā tūkua hunga, i raro huki nā mana ka tango te uke i wā, o te mātua tanga o wei ua taka ume nā nei ha kono, mā wai hei tau toko, hei tūtu pau wau, ake, 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 ake.
Thank you. kicking off in this court hearing today. I just want to say this is Selwyn Clark and myself, Barney Clarky, here to adjudicating the court hearing, and with Manahi Parapara Mohini here on my left and Georgie Job for the Maori government, which is part of this whole process. So I want to just say thank you for coming, because this is a landmark decision making for this country in the history of a snapshot of today and before and ahead. It's never been done before. So I'm glad that we are in this situation today as a last resort of justice, and this was the only path left to go. So Bundy will be enforcement officer for this Auckland Native Magistrate Court. I'll explain that shortly, but I want to introduce our panel of judges here today, Native Court judges, in a magistrate court sense of the word when this flag was first commissioned in 1834. On my right side, which is the King's side of British, this is British today, and 1835 on the Queen's side, we're joining those two together legally for the very first time in the history of this country to lead all nations, indigenous peoples, on the same pattern of monarchy rule over our lands. And that includes all affected native countries and their tribes watching what's happening here today. So you can pat yourselves on the back and be humble and at this point in time to lead off in this process. We have Hiriwini Karaka, 90 years old, war veteran, on the military side of this flag to represent the native here, in a sense, Maori on this side, and the original Moriori, Cook Island and Tahitian, and Arawa and the rest of the tribes in the Whakapapa here. I'll explain a little later. Hiriwini is our paramount Chief Justice adjudicating this court hearing today from a legal standpoint of British flag jurisdiction of Admiralty that made mortgages and bank loans from the Magistrate Court in Edinburgh to Westminster Magistrate Court to Okeato Magistrate Court in Kororarika in Russell Bay of Islands to Waitangi Marae Native Magistrate Court to Te Tī Marae Native Magistrate Court to Te Huku o Te Ika Marae Native Magistrate Court, now to Te Ono Waka Marae Native Magistrate Court, in history locked today for the British to take care of the business side of our partnership on the King's side. So on the left side, the Queen, the Maori government with Georgie here, Rob, and Sue Nakura. I'm familiar, I've got all that information that they have as well from the Confederation of Chiefs, is on the left-hand side of the flag, that has to address all Titiriti of Waitangi problems, Treaty of Waitangi 1840 to 1835 period. That's their responsibility in this court hearing today. And then we have Manahi Parapara Mohini of an original Moriori named to the Manukau, Tirawakato Whare Here Here Manukau, 1820, signed with Lieutenant William Simons in the Edinburgh Magistrate Court to set the whole native title from that day. Year 1820, cut off to 1834, the 1834 declaration of a war state of emergency flag. This is the Declaration of Independence flag, 1835. This today is the commercial side of the Declaration of War bank flag that we have to address the urgency. In a sense, it's It's not a war, declaration of war, it's a declaration of financial martial law to make both sides accountable for the land and resources that have been taken for private interest on this side of the royal families and not much left on this side. This is straight Hapu and King contract, and this is Queen and the Iwi Māori contract. So that defines who we are here today on this. For the people watching around the world today, it has come to this time that we are here in Rio, the people that they've been waiting for in Britain, who they will listen to from legal documents. Here you'll see behind me all the titles of this country, from this Moriori title to 1834, cut off on the Queen's side. And this side is in the real now. They have to address that issue and file it into here straight to Britain. The British, this flag has been dormant all along. It's no longer dormant today, and from the time we opened the Waitangi Marae Native King's Bench Magistrate Court. So I'll let Bundy have a talk before we proceed with the court hearing.
Ati hei wa Māori ora. Tui hea ki te rangi, tui hea ki te whenua, tui hea ke rote te ngākau tangata. Ko te mea nui o tēnei ao, ko te ānea. Ki hei wa Māori ora. E tuaka nei ki te tautoko ngā mihi i mihi ngia te ata nei. Me te kai karaki e tuku whakawhetai ki te atua ke manā ki tia mai mātou e runga tēnei mahi tino hohunu i roti e tātou i tēnei rā. E mihi ana ki tēnei o tātou nei kau mātua mō ana nei oratanga kia kite te ao ko eia te tino rangatira i wangini e tātou. Me wāna nei mahi i mahingia i roto i ngā hoia 21 taino ki tēnei wā i o roto nana o here wini karata tēnei. Me ngā mahi o tēnei o tātou nei rangatire o hakahaere ana wēnei kōrero e pāna ki o mātou nei taitara ki tā mātou nei whenua i roto i ngā ture o te kingi Wiramu. Me tēnei o tātou nei kai karakia me wāna nei mahi ki te tautoko ki te aki a tātou nei i tēnei rangi. Tēnei te mihi ki a koutou hoki e haere mai ā tinana, ā kanohi ki te kite tēnei rā tino hōhonu, tino hirahira ki a tātou, te iwi, tangata whenua, tumutumu, tangata whenua o tēnei wāhi o tātou nei o Aotearoa New Tirini. Hoku nei mahi ki te hakatakoto te kaupapa nei o ngā ture o te kīngi Wiramu i mua te aroaro o ngā prihimana me ngā kōti ārohe me te kōti teitei hoki. Kia mua hio rātou, kei tonu mātou, ki te ārihi tēnei kaupapa, i roto i a mātou nei āhuatanga, ka hore kei roto i te tamariki tanga, ku puta atu tātou i tērā i roto i ngā tiriti me te whakapūtanga. Ko tātou nei, i tino honore ki te tū, ki te kōrero, ki te mahi, wēnei mahi, i runga te tika, te pono, te āroate me te rangi mahi e. Tēnei toku nei tumanako, ke haere tātou i pērā, taino mai te timatanga ki te tutukitanga o tēnei kaupapa i tēnei rā. Mihi ana kia o tātou nei kara, i muri, ke He runga tēnei te pū o tātou nei. Ko tēnei, te āhuatanga, i kite tātou, te huarahi tika o tātou, a tangata whenua, me ngā whānau hapū, o Nutirehi, Aotearoa, Putanoa, o Moana Nui Aki. Kore hau hiani ki te kume tōro, hoenei nā kōrero he nā e tonu nei, ko te mea kē, i tika ana ke haere ngā kaupapa nei, i runga te rangi Māori. Huri rauna, huri rauna ki ngā kokonoa te pare. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou.
Listening to themselves and making their own law.
standing tall today and he's going to stand tall forever more. Koe a tamariki noko. Nore e kai mui tēne ko mihi tia nāmehi. Ko whakamoe mizi ko karakia tia nāko tariki. And I want to thank you for being here as our witness to this court, magistrate court. This is the highest court in the world. It's not the high court. It's not the district court. Oh, they made it up already. Talking about the magistrate court, my honor, my king, and my queen, oh, Moody. King Henry and Henry, we know we're not courting the magistrate. Really can't we tell me? Kara kotoa o kore o mikawana. Mikawana kia koutou. E roto fuki me tei o ngā pepa, just to finish off is the decoration. A whakamana tia te tribunal, ngā puni tūne si, te sovereign. Kia mau ke wera o ngā kore. We didn't see it out of sovereignty. Why should we see it? We're here to bring back our sovereignty. If we can do it with our spiritual teachings and our spiritual journey up the far north, up to the Te Hapo and the Rewe Wawai, a couple way to Wera Katoa, Kaka. Oki mai ki awi doing the commercial and the business side. But it worked both sides to get the balance, eh? Kia tika, kia pono, me te ara. But it really no, puri no to tātou for the te nata. Ki nā kauta, ki nā mātua, nā pai whakahare, ki nā koe e jo, e hiri mini, ki pande, ki kohoa, ki kāna kia kauta. Kia rātou rāko ki tūrangi tia, i tēnei haura tono, i tēnei haura. Hai, hai, hai. Kuri atu rā, kuri rāngu, tā koko nā o tō tātou whare, tō tātou marae, i te hāhi huki, i hāhi katorika. Kei te mihi, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, kia ora mai tātou kātou.
Sue Nikora, one of the older Confederation of Chiefs on the 1835 side, I've been involved with a long time. And so she will say a few words on to cover her part of this organisation that's going together today and address both legal issues of how to manage this land in this country. Georgie?
The court here, I just want to get straight to the point because I don't want to take the mana away from what John Wano is doing, you know, because it's really about this kaupapa. Okay, I just want to go to, I think it was the year 2010, John. Mm-hmm. The last time we sort of had our Tuakamania King Fee, that was when it was at Epsom Marae. And you were there, Danny, okay? It's just around the corner, the Marae around the corner. And that was when our rangatiras were still living. Dawe Hungi had passed away, Mohi Manuko and them had passed away. But we had Machi Tarawa was still alive, okay? Today is that this is the first time we've actually carried this through from, I think it was the 2009 or 2010, because you had put it up on Facebook.
2010. 2009 would have been the Lisbon Treaty.
Yeah.
And from that point on, the politics changed.
So this is the first time we carried it, and I'd like to, you know, thanks to Hedewini and Bundy for you know, we've been asking Ariki's up north, and so, you know, like, I pay my respect and thanks very much to Manahi, Bundy and Hedewini and Wedemu, and all the others who decided, well, we're not going to wait for everybody, we're going to do something, you know? And if it wasn't for you guys, the Wakamini Confederation of Chiefs, we'll be going nowhere. Our waka would be just like lockdown, dry docked, lockdown. But thank yous for you know, showing the initiative that we've got to do something, we've got to move. And tautoko what John Wano is doing, you know. So it's about this kaupapa that you're taking us to the next step, John Wano, and you know, on behalf of the Wakamini Confederation of Chiefs, where I was appointed by Mohi Manuko and Dao Wehungi, who have passed away, and we just thank this. Our arikis here, that if it's not wasn't for them, and the initiative Wairamu, that you've been able to pull them all up north. Well, thank you very much. You know, because the thing is that what's the point of having a government administrator if we're not going to tautoko it and move forward? You know, it's been a long time, eh, Danny? And thank you very much for your initiative to Danny, you know? Okay. That's all I have to say. I just, you know, this is the kaupapa. Kia ora.
Thank you, Alfred. I just want to make clear what we're about today, myself. My name is actually Kuani Kahaki Wānua from East Cape, in the Uataha Hapu area, from Cape Runaway to East Cape to Tikitiki, through Rangitukia to Tikitiki, to Hiruharama and Rotorua Range, down to Cape Runaway. All that area is Uataha, and Uepohapu is Sunakura, in the Hiruharama area, Hiruharama, Marae area up towards Tolaga Bay. So we go hand in hand on the East Cape with Marianne Court titles, and she has all the records of the big books, for that if I need to call on any court records that are in Gisborne, the land court there. And we go back, I just want to say where my family fits in. The Wānuas are from Rapa Nui, East Island, to Mokonui, big shrine, midday in Rapa Nui, or East Island, to Mokonui, big face, at the East Gate Tipitoa. That's the birth of New Zealand there, or when the migrations came into Rangitukia, the first migrations, and that history is Toi Kai Rātou, Hikarangi, that's his maunga and his homestead, and the same Toi Kai Rātou to Te Hapua, and that connection to the Cook Islands, which is what I'm doing here on our East Cape titles, connected to Te Hapua, and Bundy comes from there, and Hiriwini and Manahi. Manahi is from Rangitukia, and we are connected to each other with the paraparas and the mauhinis, and one was there for a long time. But we connect the Moriori there to the Cook Island, because on my mother's side, Kaika comes from Rarotonga, or from the Cook Islands, Aitutaki area, and my father is Tahitian. So that's the connection to the East Cape, and especially for our day to day, the Whakawhitira Native Magistrate Court in Rotorua Tikitiki, on the way to Rotorua, next to the Hiruharama Marae and Ngāti Kurangi. Now that magistrate court there is connected to the St. Mary's Church in Tikitiki, 1831. These are all titles that started the birth, death and marriage certificates that are well and truly used inside this flag for mortgages on land, as the first in the world there, to the Holy Grail, which is in Edinburgh, Magistrate Court area, St. Mary's Church there. That's where the Holy Grail is buried underneath there. So that history to my Wānuā, Rogan, Northern Ireland, Whakapapa there, the coat of arms, and the Cosgrove lawyers, Rogan judges. And the Rogans put these titles together with the Manukau's in for New Zealand, with that Edinburgh Magistrate Court, 1820, Tira Waikato, Whareherea there, Manuka. The other one, the other chief, paramount, these are both paramount chiefs, he's from Waikato, Maungatauteri Mountain Park, that's his park. And he, and the other, that's Manahi's side to look after, that side of the history straight to Britain. And for Bundy, and with Hongihika, paramount chief, they both went to England in 1820 and went to Cambridge University to learn English. But Hongi looked after the armed side of the protection. magistrate courts are the only courts that are foreign policies between one state and the other because of the shipping trade. And the manifest on the dock and the of the bay and berthing of ships and birth certificates. So I'm in the line of intelligence from my own roving background in Northern Ireland. Now you'll see that the 8-point star I have on my hat here is St. Patrick. Now that where that comes into our flag is the St. Patrick's in Northern Ireland, Belfast. You'll see now that the Prime Minister has gone with her partner of the DUP party because they're from Belfast as Protestant. So I can very well say I'm a Protestant from Ireland on that side and Tahitian on the Maori section side on the other side. So we have two memorials, very powerful in commercial sense, that's been hidden as banks secret. The 8-point star is municipalities to collect the rent off the conquered lands and for the leased lands right through the world. And so all I'm saying today is this flag has a lot of legal elements in it that have been dormant for 183 years since 1834, when they gave that flag. As soon as Captain Dorothy Ship, Captain James Reed Clinton, and said the land of the king, that formed the title straight away, a British title. The other title is Fashion, 1835, Australia, New South Wales, out of this. Queen Victoria, Queen Elizabeth, the second of Rothschild Banks. This one is straight King Bench Court, which is today, and we are a second party in contract with the King, and it's unbroken until we go to England to change the partnership of Admiralty. This side has still got its contract through the New Zealand Company, New South Wales, Australia, to deal with. So the Maori government has to fashion itself in today's world on this side. They don't really care because this Queen are using this flag for themselves and their own. It's a private contract, nobody's business. So we are private commercial landowners on this panel and not, in an Ariki sense, has nothing to do with commercial trading and banks and money and all of that sort of thing. You need to have this to play the game, and they're at the very highest level. We have the most powerful memorials to land in the world. King William's flag, his memorial as a trading partner, two-party contract through the magistrate court, and we have the Maui statue standing in London, and standing in Dunedin, and standing in Auckland, standing in Washington DC, New York, Brussels, France, London, Singapore, Chile, the most powerful countries in the world are holding our Moai as a commercial entity. They're using our spirit of God's law, L-O-R-E, truth, deeds of truth, to smother everyone with, because it is a pirate's flag given to us to ward off pirates. Now, the black strippers, it's there because it's a protectorate from the Navy, Royal British Navy, and military. In times like this, we can call on. We are calling on the British military to fix the problem in Wellington because they have run off with this title from the King's Bench Court as a Queen's Bench Court administrator of the King's Bench Court's royal revenue, prized possessions, and lease lands, and everything else that's been accumulated from his title belongs to these paramount chiefs. So I'm putting the paramount chiefs in place to administer the land here. Bundy has an overarching title to the country. The Maori government talks to him because he's straight to Britain on this two-party contract And this is the third party. The Maori government will fix up the third party and transition back into the safety of the King's Bench Court with no debt, no mortgages, no nothing on this side. That's what we're doing with this court case today, is take the mortgage off the land and put it back into customary title. We don't need mortgages. So that's the point of what I'm saying today. Bundy is in a land commissioner, native land commissioner's role as administering the land. You need a government of sorts. It'll take a while for them to catch up to speed because we have an overarching Maui Crown, that's the Maui statue standing in London, Maui Crown, federal state government of the world. This is covering the whole world where they took this land and won't have it. And so I've guessed where it went to. It's not up to them to make that call. We make the call to make them accountable, and we have King Tafio's Crown notes to use as instruments against any complaint against this crown, New Zealand's crown, straight to the British crown and the Maori crown standing in London and standing in Auckland. The Kari Head, the one in Auckland in the museum, and the one in Dunedin has his crown on his head. They put it there, the crown, Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth, put it there because of the crown on his head. The other countries, they've walked them off. Even in Britain, they took the crown off and assumed they are the crown. I'm talking about God's crown to God's earth, his mother. So that's a very powerful memorial to the land, Ahu Whenua, with his base, his Ahu, and his land, Whenua, underneath. So all we have to do is stand beside him, stand beside the king and the flag over there, and we're in business, as it should have been a long time. But it's taken a long time to get it across to our people, but they will eventually get it and get up to speed because we're going straight into the mainstream after this with confidence. These men have got confidence, especially Hiriwi. He is the first of the settlers here that have settled themselves, but he's got a bone to pick with his ancestors in England. He can go there, I think he'd be like giving a bottle of whiskey, right? But to go there and stand there and say, right, you didn't tell us what the deal was. And so we're calling the shots of the deal of where to from here. And so that's all I need to say about that and myself. Why am I going there to live as the ambassador for all the countries, 250 countries with their flag? I'm saying it was the 250 countries. It's up to them to say it didn't. And I'm saying today, it's 970 million trillion pound note, one single pound note, the bill. And we're going to force it today. And it's up to them to tell me it's not that figure, it's this figure. So we are assessing the damage in one lock, stock, barrel, native, right through the world, because they use this blueprint as their precedent case, right through the world, for the Queen's Maori people and their title that they fashioned out the New Zealand Crown, government in Wellington, they fashioned that land title. You can carry on being Maori, but you take the Maori away from them, and you'll find that they are the ones that have been taking all the money for themselves. Now, the latest is Judith Collins has, with her Chinese husband, dug up the Kauri Lodge up north before Marsden Point, and that's where the fuel line split. They're not too bothered about fuel frying everywhere and spilling out. They're not bothered about that. They want the money from the logs. They're about 1 million each, Kauri log, that they sold off to the Chinese. We've got a bone to pick with the mana whenua, tangata whenua, of the land there. These are some more claims after Cook Street. That's just the first one, right through the world. I'll make this statement. It's fact cited evidence on these videos. So that's what gave me the case in Auckland that they wouldn't let me in court. I've never had my day in court. This isn't my day in court because the system, the justice system, won't work for me in barring me from going to court. And so we'll put this case straight into the Westminster Magistrate Court in Westminster City, outside of the London City, Westminster, in the Trafalgar Square. That's where the Admiralty building.